Hi friends, this is Sajina. Today we can see industrial production of glutamic acid. Amino acids are playing an important role in our life. They are the building blocks of proteins. They play an important role in regulation of metabolism in living organisms. And these amino acids, they can be produced by various methods. And amino acids are widely used in the production of peptide-derived chemotherapeutics. This also increases the importance of amino acids. They are chiral compounds. They are the building blocks of various fine chemicals. They are used as nutrients, flavoring agents in pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, etc. And these amino acids, they can be produced by chemical synthesis, isolation from natural materials, through fermentation process and chemoenzyme methods. Glutamic acid is one of the important amino acid. Here we are going to see the production of glutamic acid production. And the glutamic acid, it was discovered by Rithausen in 1866. And in 1908, Professor Ikeda found that the material enhancing the taste of seaweed soup, it came from a sodium salt of this glutamic acid, that is monosodium glutamate. You all know that monosodium glutamate is Ajinomoto. Nowadays, we are widely using this monosodium glutamate as a flavor enhancing agent. And the demand of glutamic acid, it is increasing day by day. And in 1956, glutamic acid was mainly obtained by the hydrolysis of plant proteins. And it was in 1956, Japanese investigators found that glutamic acid can be produced by microbiological methods and began the industrial production. Glutamic acid is an alpha amino acid. It contains an alpha amino group with a protonated NH3+ and a carboxylic group with a deprotonated COOO-. Then, and a side chain carboxylic acid, it's a polar negatively charged amino acid, aliphatic amino acid. Applications we have already discussed, that is flavor enhancing agent, nutritional supplement. Then it can be used in the treatment of hair loss. It helps to prevent aging. It can be used as a nutritional supplement for animal feed and also used as intermediate in manufacturing of various organic chemicals. The various microorganisms involved in amino acid production are Cornibacterium species, Bravibacterium species, Microbacterium and Arthrobacter. The organisms must satisfy some of the properties. That is, the organism must be capable of producing spores so that they can be easily inoculated. And the organism must grow rapidly on a large scale in an inexpensive medium. They must produce the desired product quickly. They must not be pathogenic, and then they must be capable of genetic manipulations. Wild type strains of organisms of the four genera can be used for the production of glutamic acid, but the preferred organism is Cornibacterium glutamicum. The properties of glutamic acid bacteria are, they are all gram positive, non-motile, require biotin to grow, and they lack enzyme alpha ketoglutarate. Coming to the conditions of fermentation, the first requirement is a medium for the growth of the microorganism, and the composition of the medium is given below. The main ingredients are glucose, corn stebe liquor, enzymatic casein hydrolysate, dipotassium hydrogen phosphate, magnesium sulfate and urea. Glucose, it is the main carbon source. Then in addition to glucose or instead of glucose, we can use hydrocarbons as carbon source for glutamic acid production. Optimal temperature is 30 to 35 degrees Celsius. High degree of aeration is necessary for the process. The biochemical basis of glutamic acid production, the main important factor is biotin. It is acting as a limiting factor. The biotin level, it must be kept suboptimal. Because if the biotin level is optimal, the microorganism will grow faster and they start secreting lactic acid. Therefore, higher amounts of glutamic acid production, with higher amounts of biotin, glutamic acid production, it will fall. So, it must be kept suboptimal. Then isocitrate succinate part of TCA cycle is needed for the growth, and only after the growth phase, the optimal glutamic acid production starts. An increase in the permeability of the cell is necessary so as to permit the outward diffusion of glutamic acid. The permeability of the bacterial cell can be achieved by various methods, that is by ensuring biotin deficiency in medium, or by treatment with fatty acid derivatives, or by ensuring oleic acid deficiency in mutants requiring oleic acid, or by addition of penicillin during growth of glutamic acid bacteria. Using any of these methods, we can increase the cell permeability. Here, while adding this or while choosing these methods, what happens is the saturated to unsaturated fatty acid ratio in the cell membrane of the bacteria become abnormal. Therefore, the permeability barrier is destroyed and glutamic acid get accumulated in the medium. The major factor in glutamic acid production by wild type organism is thus altered permeability. Treatment with penicillin prevents the cell wall formation. Manufacturing process of glutamic acid comprises three steps: fermentation, crude isolation, purification process. Three types of fermentation methods can be used for glutamic acid production. They are batch fermentation, fed batch fermentation, and continuous fermentation. The fermenter process, the first method or the first step in fermentation, is the production of inoculum. The inoculum or the starter culture, it is grown in a shake flask and is transferred to a first seed tank having 1 to 2 liters size. After suitable growth, the inoculum is transferred to a second seed tank having more size, that is 10,000 to 20,000 liters capacity. This serves as inoculum for the production tank, that is, this is transferred to the production tank. The fermentation is usually batch or fed batch. In batch cultivation, all the nutrients are added at once at the beginning of the fermentation except ammonia. Ammonia is added only intermittently to adjust the pH, and the fermentation continues until sugar is exhausted. Okay, coming to the batch fermentation again, it is widely used for the production of amino acids. It's a closed system, that is, nutrients are added initially, ammonia is added intermittently to adjust the pH, and the fermentation continues until the sugar is exhausted. A short adaptation time is usually necessary for the cells before logarithmic phase. We have already heard about lag phase. It's a time, or it's a short adaptation time, and after that they enter the logarithmic phase, and the nutrition or nutrients soon become limited and they enter the stationary phase. Glutamic acid fermentation, the production starts in the early logarithmic phase and continues through the stationary phase. For economical reasons, the fermentation time, it should be as short as possible with a high yield of amino acid at the end, and also the production time must be short, otherwise there is a chance of appearance of contaminant products. The lag phase can be shortened by using a higher concentration of seed inoculum. Second one is fed batch fermentation, that is, batch fermentation which are fed continuously or intermittently with medium without the removal of fluid. That is fed batch fermentation. That is, it is fed continuously or intermittently, but there is no removal of spent medium. In this way, the volume of the culture increases with time. The residual substrate concentration may be maintained at a very low level. This may result in the removal of catabolite repressive effects and avoid the toxic effects of medium components. Oxygen balance is very important, and the feed rate of the carbon source can be used to regulate the cell growth. Then, oxygen limitation can be used to regulate cell growth rate, especially when oxygen demand is high in the exponential growth phase. Third one is continuous fermentation. In continuous fermentation, an open system is set up, that is, sterile nutrients are added continuously and equivalent amount of converted nutrient solution with microorganism is removed from the system. Natural products such as sugarcane can be used as carbon source, mainly sugarcane molasses. The heat sterilized raw materials and other nutrients are put in the tank. Microorganism is added to the fermentation broth. The microorganism reacts with sugar to produce glutamic acid, and the fermentation broth is acidified and glutamic acid is crystallized. Coming to the separation and purification process, we can see different methods are available: centrifugation, filtration, crystallization, ion exchange, electrodialysis, solvent extraction, declarization, and evaporation. Downstream processing, that is the product recovery. After fermentation, the cells may be filtered using a rotary vacuum filter. Then the filtration can be improved using filter aids. One example is Kieselguhr, which is a diatomaceous earth-based filter. It improves the filtration rate. The extraction methods of amino acid from the filtrate depends upon the level of purity desired in the product. Two methods are mainly involved, chromatographic method and the concentration crystallization method. First one is crystallization method. It is used as a method to recover amino acid. Due to the amphoteric character of amino acids, their solubility is greatly influenced by the pH of the solution. Temperature also influences the solubility of amino acids and their salts. Lowering the temperature can be used in advance as means of obtaining the required product. Precipitation of amino acid with salts like ammonium and calcium salts and with metals like zinc can also be used. Next is ion exchange. Resins have been widely used for the extraction and purification of amino acids from the fermentation broth. Adsorption of amino acid by ion exchange resins is strongly affected by the pH of the solution and the presence of contaminant ions. There are two types of ion exchange resins, cation exchange resins and anion exchange resins. Cation exchange resins, they bind positively charged amino acids. Anion exchange resins bind negatively charged amino acids. This is the flow diagram of commercial production of glutamic acid. Here we can see a sugar tank. This sugar tank, the sugar is sterilized and is passed through a buffer tank and then it is added to the production fermenter. Then similarly, the nutrients, they are dissolved, they are sterilized, then it is passed through a buffer tank and then it is added to the fermenter. Then anti-foam agent, it is also sterilized and it is added into the production fermenter. This anti-foam agent is added in order to prevent foam formation. Then after that, we can see the seed fermenter is there, or seed tank, which is providing the inoculum. The inoculum is added into the fermenter. After that, fermentation is started. Here, air supply is given. Sterile air is continuously supplied. It is continuously supplied, and exhausted air, it is removed. Here we can see an air filter, and filtered air is supplied to the fermenter. Then ammonia, it is added for pH control. Here also we can see supply of ammonia. Then the fermentation, it is continued. Then after fermentation, we can harvest the medium into a harvesting tank. Therefore, this is the flow diagram of commercial production of glutamic acid. Then the glutamic acid crystal is added to sodium hydroxide solution for production of monosodium glutamate. Monosodium glutamate, it is more soluble in water and less likely absorb moisture and has strong taste. And it is cleaned by using active carbon. The clean MSG solution is concentrated by heating and crystals will be formed. The crystals produced are dried with a hot air in a closed system. And the crystals can be packed and are ready to be sold. Separation and purification. Okay, monosodium glutamate, which can cause headaches, fatigues, palpitations, nausea and vomiting, sweating, flushing and numbness of the face more so among people who are sensitive to it. It can also cause hypertension and extremely hazardous for pregnant women. According to some reports, regular use of these ingredients can cause long-term issues like high blood pressure, autism, hormonal imbalance, epilepsy, food allergies, asthma, reduction in bile formation, cancer, and possibly sterility in females. Therefore, we have to reduce the consumption of monosodium glutamate. That's all about the commercial production of glutamic acid. Hope you all understand the session. Thank you.